Hi students, all of you good morning, welcome to the class. Of course, all of you good afternoon. Today's our topic is line spectrum of hydrogen atom. In the last class we discussed that whenever a hydrogen gas is taken in an electric discharge tube and that discharge tube is going to have very low pressures means evacuated vacuum, so the gas is taken under low pressure and the gas is subjected to high voltage electric discharge. We are taking the hydrogen gas. If the hydrogen gas is taken, that is going to contain so many molecules. So first of all, the molecules are dissociating into atoms, so then we get hydrogen atoms. After some time, again by taking the electrical energy, more than 13.6 electron volts energy, the electrons in the hydrogen atoms are going to get excite into different levels. So the electrons may get excite to second level, third level, fourth level, fifth level, sixth level and seventh level, where the electrons from the ground level to any excited level, if the electrons are going to move by absorbing energy, that process is called as excitation process. But all of you know, if any electron is there in the excited state, the electron is unstable. The excited electron is going to emit radiation. Once again, the excited electron is going to emit radiation in the form of electromagnetic waves. So here, when the excited electron is present in the seventh level and the excited electron is going to get de-excite directly to the first level. So from the any higher energy level to, first level, if the excited electrons are going to get a de-excite, then we will get a group of spectral lines. That group of spectral lines obtained is called as Lyman series. We cannot see this Lyman series because this Lyman series spectral lines are obtained in the UV region. We cannot see the UV region. So we cannot able to, or we are unable to observe the Lyman series formed in the hydrogen spectrum. But when the excited electrons are in any excited state, they are de-exciting to, the excited electrons are de-exciting to second level. These excited electrons are going to get de-excited to second level. Again, we will get a group of spectral lines. That group of spectral lines are going to be formed in the visible region. We can say the visible region. That means this group of spectral lines can be observed by the naked eye. That was first time observed by the scientist Balmer. Here L is silent, Balmer. Hence this group of spectral lines in the hydrogen spectrum obtained in the visible region observed by the Balmer. Hence this group of spectral lines is named as Balmer series. So Balmer series is obtained in n is equal to 2. Lyman series is obtained in n is equal to 1. Like that, if the excited electrons of hydrogen atoms de-excite to third level, this is the third level. When the excited electrons of hydrogen atoms are going to get de-excited to third level, then we will get a group of spectral lines. They are called as Paschen series. And this series is formed in the near of the infrared region. Like that, if the excited electrons are de-exciting to fourth level, then we will get a group of spectral lines. This group of spectral lines are called as bracket series. It is going to be formed in the middle of the infrared region. And if the excited electrons of the hydrogen atoms are going to get de-excite to fifth level, the excited electrons of hydrogen atoms are going to get de-excite to fifth level. This is the fifth level. Then we will get a group of spectral lines. They were named as P-Fun series. If the P is silent, then we can say it is as Fun series, and it is formed in the far infrared region. So this is the formation of line spectrum of hydrogen atom when the hydrogen gas is going to get discharged in the electric discharge tube subjected to high voltage of electricity, more than 13.6 electron volts. Anyhow, so we are having different types of series. In the hydrogen spectrum, we are having different types of series. The first series is called as Lyman series, formed in the UV region. For the Lyman series, ground state is equal to 1. For the Lyman series, ground state is equal to 1. For the Lyman series, excited states are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on, infinity. For the Balmer series, ground state is n is equal to 2. That is, n1 is equal to 2. n1 is equal to 2. Ground state is, for Balmer series, n1 is equal to 2. For the Balmer series, excited states are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on, infinity. Like that for the Pasteur series, ground state, that is n1 value is equal to 3. And for the Pasteur series, excited states are 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on, infinity. Like that we can say for bracket series and we can say for P fund series. As already in the last class also I explained the same. Now, suppose if we are going to consider the visible region, because we can able to see the visible region, how many lines are obtained here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Of course, we can also count like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you'll get it out. In this Balmer series, which is the first line? How can you say the first line? If you take this one as the first line, this excited electron from the third level coming to the second level. Here, in the Balmer series, this spectral line is formed by the de-excitation of electron from third level to second level. This is the spectral line formed by the de-excitation of electron from fourth level to second level. This is from fifth level to second level, sixth level to second level, seventh level to second level. This is from third level to second level, fourth level to second level, fifth level to second level, sixth level to second level, seventh level to second level. A group of spectral lines are obtained that are named as Balmer series. Now you can guess among these lines, whether the left side line is first line or the right side line is the first line. In this group of spectral line, in this group of spectral lines, which one is the first line? Whether the left line is the first line or right line is the first line? Text me your answer. In the Balmer series, I'm not asking about colors, man. I'm not asking about colors. I'm not asking about colors. I'm asking about these lines. This line, this line, this line, this line, this line. Right to left. Right to left. Whether the right to left are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or left to right is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which one is the first line? Which one is the first line? From left to right is the first line or right to left is the first line means left, right to left is the first line. Yes, see me? This is the right hand side of my. This is the left hand side. So from the right hand side, this is the first line. This line is taken as H alpha line. This line is taken as H beta line. This line is taken as H gamma line. This line is taken as H delta line. H delta line. Next line is taken as H alpha beta gamma delta. Next one is omega line. Omega line. We are not going to say about omega line. I am going to consider the four lines. Four lines of Balmer series. So which one is the H alpha line of Balmer series? In the CET, it will be asked. Balmer series indicates H alpha line, H beta line, H gamma line, H delta line. So many lines are there and they are obtained in the visible region. In the Balmer series, if H alpha line is taken, what are the N values? What is the N1 value? What is the N2 value? N1 indicates lower energy level. Lower energy level. N2 indicates higher energy level. So in the Balmer series, for the H alpha line, this is the H alpha line. For the H alpha line, what is the N1 value and what is the N2 value? N1 means ground state, N2 means excited state. Yes, can anybody guess? For this line, H alpha line, this is the H alpha line of Balmer series. What is the ground state value and what is the excited state value of H alpha line? What is the N1 value? What is the N2 value? What is the N1 value? Yes, N1 value means ground state. This is the ground state. For Balmer series, this is the ground state. That means N1 is equal to. For the Balmer series, ground state is N1 is equal to 2. And for the Balmer series, H alpha line is formed from third level to second level. So in the Balmer series, for the H alpha line, excited state. Once again, in the Balmer series, for H alpha line, the excited state, nothing but N2 is equal to, what is the N2 value? Yes, N2 value is equal to 3. So based on this, you will get the bits or MCQs regarding CET or NEET. Of course, in JEE also, but in the JEE, mostly the problems is asked based on formulas. Mostly the problems will be asked based on formulas, based on concepts and based on synopsis. The questions is going to be asked in CET and NEET. So to get the best rank in the CET and NEET, if you are going through the concepts properly and if you are able to understand the concepts properly, you can easily get the best rank, best marks in CET and NEET. But to get the best rank in the JEE, you have to solve the problems which are going to be solved by using mathematical formulas. Later we'll discuss that one. Anyhow, in the Balmer series for H alpha line, first option, N1 is equal to 2, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to 4, first option. Second option, for H alpha line of Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to 5. Third option, for the H alpha line of Balmer series, N1 is equal to 3, N2 is equal to 4. Fourth option, H alpha line of Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to 3. Then we will select the fourth option. Like that, the bits will be asked for CET and NEET. So please try to purchase the material from the college as soon as possible, because after the completion of every topic, we are going to discuss the MCQs. If you are having the material, then it will be very easy to understand the MCQs. So without having material, without having textbook, without having notebook, how can you understand? So I'm requesting you all, please try to purchase the materials as soon as possible. So anyhow, coming to the point, in the textbook, in the NCERT textbook, only three series are given. Lyman series in the UV region, Balmer series in the visible region, Passion series in the near IR region. These three are only given. I'm going to discuss only about Balmer series. Yes, on the screen, you can see now. Yes, on the screen, you can see the Balmer series. Yes, if you see the Balmer series, wait a minute. Yes, you are seeing the Balmer series. Yes, once check the Balmer series, H alpha line, H beta line, H gamma line, H delta line. Yes, you will get a doubt. Sir, you written in the reverse manner. You written in the reverse manner. No need to worry. We can write in any manner. So here H alpha line. See this one, H alpha line of Balmer series. The H alpha line of Balmer series is formed from the d excitation of excited electron from third level to, see this one, N is equal to 3. N is equal to 3 is the third level. So excitation of electrons from third level to second level, that is indicating H alpha line of Balmer series, and that emitted radiations are having that emitted radiations. When we see that emitted radiations, they appear as red color radiations. So simply we can say that H alpha line of Balmer series appears as red color radiation. You have to remember. Next, H beta line means when the electron is going to de-excite from N is equal to 4. This is N is equal to 4 to N is equal to 2. Then some energy is going to get emit. That emitted radiation appears in the green color. So that is the line. This is the second line of Balmer series. That is called as H beta line. So for the H beta line of Balmer series, N1 is equal to, N1 means ground state. For H beta line, see this one. For H beta line, N1 is equal to 2. N2 is equal to 4. And similarly, if you go for the H gamma line, H gamma line means which color? This is the color, blue color. So H gamma line is obtained from de-excitation of electron from the fifth level to, the de-excitation of electron from fifth level to second level is going to happen. Then emission of some radiation is going to happen. That emitted radiation appear in the form of a blue colored radiation. So then the line is called as H gamma line. like that we can say the emission of energy by the de-excitation of electrons from sixth level to de-excitation of electrons from sixth level to, this is the sixth level to second level, then some energy is going to be emitted that will appear in the violet color form. So in the Balmer series, that is a visible region, we are going to have a different group of spectral lines. We can see the different group of spectral lines. Here you can see the different group of spectral lines. Actually, I have written like this, but in the textbook it is given in a reverse manner. Both are same. No need to confuse. Right? Both are same. So this is the H alpha line. This is the H beta line. This is the H gamma line. This is the H delta line. This will be called as H omega line. H omega. 1, 2, 3, 4 are numerical numbers. The numbers in the Greek terminology. The numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 in the Greek terminology is called as alpha, beta, gamma, delta, omega, epsilon, and so on. That will come in mathematics. So here I'm saying only about 4 lines of Balmer series. They are visible. H alpha line is red color. H beta line is which type of color? The H beta line is which type of color it is? You have to remember the colors. H alpha line is red color. H beta line is green color. H gamma line is blue color. H delta line is violet color. Here you have to remember these values also. I am sending the PDF every day. Please try to write the notes in the running notes. Whatever the PDF I am sending, please write in the running notes. Please try to maintain a separate notes for my classes. Please try to maintain a separate notes for my classes. So anyhow, this is all about line spectrum of hydrogen atom. Once again, I'm saying this is about line spectrum. Lines. Here, what you can see? Formation of lines. So this is a spectrum. Spectrum is nothing but group of electromagnetic radiations. So this is a group of electromagnetic radiations. This is a group of electromagnetic radiations. This is a group of electromagnetic radiations. And these two also. So all these are indicating it is a spectrum of hydrogen atom. And during the emission of radiation, that radiations are going to be collected on a photographic film. We will get the lines formation. Hence, the obtained spectrum is called as line spectrum. And it is all about only hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom, it contains how many electrons? Hydrogen atom contains how many electrons? Yes, hydrogen atom contains only one electron. So this is the atomic spectrum. This is the atomic spectrum of hydrogen atom and hydrogen-like species. Once again, this is the atomic spectrum of hydrogen atom and hydrogen-like species. Later we will discuss what is hydrogen-like species. Right, before going to that one. Here, suppose if this line is taken, which line is considered? H alpha line is considered of Balmer series. In the H alpha line of Balmer series, ground state N1 is equal to 2, excited state N2 is equal to 3. So from N2 is equal to 3 to N1 is equal to 2, what is happening? From N2 is equal to 3 to N1 is equal to 1, sorry, from N2 is equal to 3 to N2 value. N2 value means excited state. N2 is equal to 3 to N1 is equal to 2. Here, what is happening? Right, correct. De-excitation of excited electrons of hydrogen atoms. That means emission of energy in the form of electromagnetic radiations. Energy is going to get emitted. Energy formula, according to the Planck's quantum theory, energy formula E is equal to H nu, where nu is equal to C by lambda. So for every spectral line, what we can calculate? For all these spectral lines, we can calculate the energy emitted by the excited electrons. So energy emitted by the excited electrons of hydrogen atom, capital E is equal to H nu, or capital E is equal to H into C by lambda, because nu is equal to C by lambda. And from all of this, we can also calculate wave number. Wave number is nothing but nu bar. Nu bar is called as wave number. Suppose we have lambda is taken. 1 by lambda means reciprocal of wavelength. Reciprocal of wavelength is called as wave number. So for all these spectral lines of line spectrum of hydrogen atom, we can calculate wave number for each spectral line, and that is calculated by the scientist Rydberg. The name of the scientist is Rydberg. Rydberg calculated the wave numbers of all these emitted spectral lines by using the formula nu bar. Nu bar means wave number of the spectral line. Nu bar is equal to RH. Here RH means Rydberg's constant. Here RH is known as Rydberg's constant. Nu bar, that is a wave number. Nu bar is equal to RH into 1 by N1 square, 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Here RH is called as Rydberg's constant, and the Rydberg constant is given as 109,677 centimeter inverse. Why centimeter inverse here? Why? Because means here N1 indicates lower energy level. That is number 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. N1 indicates lower energy level. N2 indicates higher energy level. They also indicates the numbers. So N1 value is the number. N2 is the number. So here RH is going to have the units of centimeter inverse. Then RH is equal to 109,677 centimeter inverse. This value is called as Rydberg's constant. And this equation, nu bar is equal to RH into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. This equation is called as Rydberg's equation. So this is all about a line spectrum of a hydrogen atom. And my dear students, this is important for JEE, Joint Entrance Examination. JEE means Joint Entrance Examination. Throughout the India, for each and every state, in the every state, one engineering college is there, that is called as NIT. NIT, National Institute of Technology, NIT. In the Telangana state, NIT is there at Warangal. In Andhra Pradesh, NIT is there at Tadapalli Gudem. I don't know NIT where it is present in Karnataka state. So like that, for each and every state, one separate engineering college with all facilities by the AICTE is provided. That engineering colleges are called as NITs, National Institute of Technologies. So in those engineering colleges, if you want to select, you have to write the examination JEE, Joint Entrance Examination. So for that examination only, this type of calculation parts will be asked. So otherwise, if you are preparing for CET and NEET, it's enough. You have to go through the concepts. With the help of that concepts, you have to solve the MCQs. So those who are preparing for KSET and NEET, you can easily get the ranks if you are going through the textbook properly. That's enough. But for JEE, there is a little bit, hardness is there. Of course, it is not a hardness. If you can solve more number of MCQs based on the formulas, then you can easily get the good rank. So getting the seat or getting the marks is easy as well as difficult. If you are ready to practice, it is very easy. If you are having no interest, it is very, very, very difficult. Anyhow, coming to the point, today's point. So today we are discussing the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. And our next topic is, on the screen, you can see the next topic. Bohr's model of hydrogen atom. Yes, wait a minute. I have to take the attendance. Then I will continue the session. Please wait a minute, ma. Please wait a minute. After taking the attendance, some students are logging out. Everything, each and everything is going to be recorded on my side. In my laptop, everything is getting recorded. You have to stay at the end of the class, up to the end of the class. Just by tapping my mobile backside 2 times, I will get the screenshot. Yes, the attendance is over. Yes, coming to that topic, next topic. Bohr's model of hydrogen atom. From the last classes, from the last nearly 10 to 12 classes, we are discussing the topic atomic structure or structure of atom. The first model of atom is, what is the first model of atom? What is the first atomic model we studied? What is the first atomic model we studied? Can anybody say? What is the first atomic model we studied? No. No. It is the Thomson's model of atom. It is the Thomson's model of atom. That is the first model of atom. That is having some drawbacks. That's why next we studied about Rutherford's model of atom. Rutherford's model of atom. That is the second one. Rutherford model of atom is also having drawbacks. That's why we are going to study the next atomic model. That is the Thomson's model of atom. Sorry. The next atomic model is Niels Bohr's model of atom. Niels Bohr's model of atom. Here is the word Niels Bohr. Niels Bohr is the scientist in the 1913. He first time explained the general features of structure of hydrogen atom and its spectrum. Okay, Niels Bohr, on which basis he is going to explain the structure of atom? Of course, Niels Bohr is explained only the structure of hydrogen atom. He didn't explain the structure of any other atom. So he is going to explain only the structure of hydrogen atom. On which basis? Yes, he considered two theories. The first one is Rutherford's model of atom, Rutherford's model of atom, and the second one is Planck's quantum theory. Once again, Niels Bohr considered two theories. One is the Rutherford's model of atom, and second one is the Planck's quantum theory. With the help of these two theories, now the Niels Bohr is going to explain the atomic model of hydrogen atom. Just a minute. Just a minute, ma. Okay, sorry for the inconvenience. So, of course, the time is 6 minutes is there. I'm not going to continue the session because we are having some meeting. In the next class means on the next Thursday itself, I'm going to take the class. Right, thank you for watching my video lectures. If you are having any doubt, you have to call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. only. But from tomorrow onwards, I'm on leave up to Monday. I will be back on Tuesday. So please call me after Tuesday only. Please don't disturb me during this leave period. Thank you. Thank you one and all. Yes, text me in the chat box whether the class is understood or not. Text me in the chat box whether the class is understood or not. If the class is understood, please purchase the material. Please purchase the material from the college and try to practice the MCQs. Please try to practice the MCQs which were given in our college material. Please try to purchase as soon as possible. And soon the colleges will get reopened. Soon we will announce that date. Right? Thank you, Anadol. Yes, still some students are not getting responded. All the students must give your response in the chat box. Please give your response in the chat box. Some students are not interested even to type the message. Okay, anyhow. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day.